Now we have a fresh updated CentOS operating system, okay? And now the first thing to do is to go to this right side icon and check your internet connection. It's a wired off now, connect. Now we are have a connection to internet, okay? And I want to change this background, okay? And always make your background image a symbol, okay? We need to change the background, so click background. I need a solid color and I prefer this color and select. It has been applied and close, okay? Now the first thing to do in your Linux system, ensure that you have a very good browser, web browser, okay? Because your web browser is your online help, your window to the world, your window to the internet, okay? Now we have by default the Linux system has a Firefox web browser default installed on it, and Firefox is one of the very good web browsers, okay? And they choose Firefox the default web browser because it's an open source web browser, okay? Now maybe you are familiar with Chrome, also one of the most well performance web browser, okay? So now we will install another web browser to your operating system. Just write www.google.com and enter, okay? And now this is a Google, okay? Change language to English, okay? And now we need to install Chrome. Just write Chrome and enter, okay? And Google Chrome, download Chrome today. Press this link. And now this is the default page for Google browser, okay? And click download Chrome. And the Chrome default web page has been detected that you are running a Linux operating system, okay? And for Fedora and OpenSUSE, we have an option here, and for Debian and Ubuntu, we have an option here. We don't see CentOS, okay? But CentOS is belong to this family, okay? With our extensions of .rpm family, okay? So choose 64-bit.rpm and then accept and install. Just wait and now save file and click OK. And here we have a progress bar for downloading. And after finish download, just click this the downloads file. And we need to click the browser, we don't need it anymore. We have a message here, just ignore it. And just wait a little while until the default installation manager recognize your package, okay, and get the package information. And now we have Google Chrome stable and click install. And it needs the root password or the administrator password. Just enter the administrator password and click authenticate. And this is the installation progress, okay. Almost done, and now we have a Google Chrome browser installed in our system. You can choose launch from here or close the installation manager and get familiar with your operating system. Go to activity. If you can't find your browser here, click show applications, and in show application we can in all we can see Chrome. In frequent we can't see because we didn't opened it yet, but we can browse or filter the application with a word and click Google Chrome. For the first time, just setting up its configurations. Okay, make it your default browser. I prefer Google Chrome over Firefox. Double click the bar to enlarge it, and now get start. Steps from here is just to personalize your Google Chrome browser, okay. Now we have Gmail, and we have all the Google services, okay. Now you can log in with your Google email to apply your personal settings, or you can create a new user, whatever what you want. All I need here is to just try YouTube to make sure that videos and audios are running okay. I choose English and okay. And now we have several videos here. What about National Geographic? It applies the English, okay. Command Jerry. Connection a little bit slow. Theater mode. Wait to buffer the video. Increase the sound. Now video is okay and the sound is okay. Now we finished the browser installation, okay, but I feel that the system is a little bit slow, and why is that? Because open the machine configuration, okay, and now we have only 1 gigabytes of RAM, okay. We need to increase the RAM 2 gigabytes or 3 gigabytes, okay. to increase the performance of the system, because the system is using something called a swap. A swap is it takes a size of your hard drive and make it as a virtual RAM, okay? And that's what makes your system a little bit slow, okay? So to increase the RAM, you need to power off your machine. This is the virtual machine, okay? And now go to setting this icon. Okay, your machine needs to be shut down to be enabled to increase the RAM. And now we increase until we have 3 gigabytes of RAM. Okay, and now open your machine again. Okay. And wait your machine to start up. I didn't want to delete this part from this video, the part of the part that CentOS is a little bit slow, okay? I wanted to figure out what is the problem and introduce this problem to you and how to solve it, okay? And if you remember in the installation video, we referred to this enter your password, enter your username is CentOS, next, password 1234, and sign in. Okay. What's the problem? Cancel CentOS 1234. We mentioned this problem in the first video, that this machine is installed with a default RAM 1 gigabytes, okay? And to increase your RAM, you need to click the machine setting and click processors and memory and increase the RAM from here. And also you can increase number of cores of processor cores assigned to your machine, okay? Now let's try the Chrome again. We have a Chrome here. And now we need to open the YouTube. www. We have a link here. We can't reach because the network connection is closed. So open the setting, wired connection, and click turn on. Okay. Now it has been opened. Click
good grammar and spelling are important, but
okay.
If you want to write essays that inspire, messages that forge brighter connections,
we can control the sound from here, okay? And now skip ads, and we have a good video with a good resolution, and we have a good sound, okay? So this video is to learn how to download and install the Google Chrome browser, okay? And we encountered our first problem and we learned how to solve it, okay? Now let's go to the next video.